Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about a common question that majority of you have been asking me, and that is, can I get deported from Estonia as a student? Well, this is a very interesting question and I'm so happy that you guys really asked me. So today I'm going to be giving you a breakdown the reasons why you could actually get deported in Estonia and even if it's possible at all to get deported from Estonia as a student. So back in 2016, when I just moved to Estonia as a student, you could actually get deported as a student very, very easily because back then you have to renew your resident permit every year. And why is that? Because back then you get only 1 year resident permit as a student, and there are some certain conditions which you need to like fulfill before you can apply for the new resident permit. So this makes it a lot easier for you to get deported as a student, because if the conditions are not met, you will not get your new resident permit and it is a goodbye, go home. So basically, and what are the conditions back then is one of the main one is actually on an average as a student, let's say you come here to study your bachelor's, which is 3 years and 180 ECTS, 180 credits basically. So on an average, you have to study 60 ECTS every year. But for the police and border, then you need to have 54 ECTS from a semester to be eligible for the next resident permit. So let's say you get a 50 ECTS from a 1 year of study, that automatically means that you will not get your next resident permit, and that is a goodbye, go home kind of situation. But it became a lot easier in 2017 when the new student didn't get the 1 year resident permit, but instead they get a resident permit for the entire study duration. So which means that if you're a bachelor student now, you get the resident permit for 3 years straight away, and if you're a master student, you get the resident permit for 2 years straight away. This is a good news, but this is also give you like the complete flexibility to plan your own studies, to say like, okay, this semester I want to study a lot, next semester I want to study less. So you are in control of your own studies. This is really nice, but I think it's only good for people that can actually handle their own situation and manage their own schedule. But for some students, they need like some kind of push, which was what the previous law, which means you have to renew your resident permit every year, gives, because you need to pass, because you need to get your next resident permit and you need to keep living like this. So yeah, but on the bright side, I like the new rule, but you can still get deported as a student if you didn't meet some certain requirement or if you failed to do some things, which are so basically, one of these things is like, let's say you are studying your bachelor's degree in Estonia and you get a 3 years resident permit and you fail to complete your studies in 3 years. Well, you will not get deported automatically, because there's another good news. As a student in Estonia, you have 9 months after your studies, which means that if your resident permit for studies expires, you get a 9 month visa to either look for a job or to actually decide if you want to stay in the country or not. And due to this reason, they assume that you have graduated from school and they give you a 9 month visa. So this 9 month visa, majority of students take advantage of it. For example, myself, we take advantage of it to like complete our studies. So let's say, for example, I'm gonna make myself an example here, because I didn't graduate from school in the 3 years nominal time that I should. I took an extra 6 months to finish my thesis and to defend it. So having this 9 month visa gave me the privilege to actually graduate from school within this 9 months, and also at the same time look for a job. And so it means that you still have 9 months to like finalize all your moves and to make your plans and to decide if you want to stay in the country or you want to leave. But if you fail to complete your studies in this 9 months, this could lead to you being deported back to your country, because one, you'll get 3 years of studies, which you already have a resident permit for, and then you get an extended 9 month visa to complete your studies or to look for a job or to plan your life, and then you still didn't like use it the right way. So I mean, I think this is not a good thing, which means if you haven't really done what is necessary to be done in 3 years and 9 months, then it means that you are not really serious about your studies, and maybe you deserve to be deported. But if you definitely have some reasons, maybe you were sick, maybe you took like some study leave and so on and so forth, there can be some other certain conditions in which you will be eligible for another resident permit, situations are different and conditions are really different. But this is one of the biggest things that could make you get deported if you didn't stick to your study plan, or if you didn't get it on time, or something happened on the way. But every situation and every case is being evaluated based on the condition and circumstances surrounding it. I don't work for the police, so I don't know much about this, but I'm just telling you the legal part of it. So basically, that is one reason why you could get deported as a student. And the second reason why you could get deported is if you decide to drop out of school without having any reasons or without having any plans. So let's say you are studying a course and for some reason you didn't like that course. You want to change your course. But as a student in Estonia, you can't just like drop out of the blue. Because immediately you drop out of school, there's no reason for you to remain in the country anymore. So let's say you want to change your course of study or maybe move to another university. First of all, you have to get into that university before you actually dematriculate yourself from your present university. Failure to do this, or failure to like dematriculate yourself before you actually get into another school, could lead to you being deported from the country, because immediately you leave your present studies, give your status away as a student, and you don't have the right to be in the country anymore. So this is not a good thing. And if there's one thing you need to keep in mind, if you plan to like change your course of study or you plan to move to another university, you have to renew your resident permit, which means that even though you have 3 years of residency from your old course, your old university, immediately you change your course or immediately you move to another university, you have to get a new resident permit, because your old resident permit was based on that university, it was based on that course of study. So now you study something totally different with a total duration of time in a different university. So you need to actually get a new resident permit. I think this is the main two reasons which could actually get you deported as a student from Estonia, aside from legal issues. Let's say maybe you get yourself into some trouble, which is not something that I want to cover in this video, because we are not looking at that. You are a student, you don't plan to break the law, you don't plan to do all those kind of stuff. So let's just focus on the things that are realistic here, and not the things that you will do because something else happens to you, or because you find yourself in the wrong place in the wrong time or whatever. So yeah. So basically, that's all for this video. Thank you all for watching my YouTube videos. If you have any question for me whatsoever, feel free to actually write down in the comment section. I will answer your questions whenever I'm free, because some of you guys actually been sending me messages on Instagram and I haven't replied a lot. Not because I don't want to reply them, but because I have a lot of messages. One, and secondly, replying to you guys privately doesn't really give other people the benefit to learn from the same question that you've asked me. And this is the main reason that I would prefer, and I would suggest you to ask me questions in the comment section, so that whenever I reply to your question, people that are coming in the future can always look through the comment section, learn from it, and maybe they have the same question which I might have already given the answer to. So this way I don't have to like repeat questions and answers like every time. So thank you all for watching this video. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to like my video, subscribe to my channel, and share with your friends that would like to study or move to Estonia or just listen to me for some reason. So thank you guys for watching and coming again, and I hope to see you guys again next week when I'm uploading a new content. And bye for now.